Hey there, my name is Kaylee. Welcome to Constant Speed Unit Rates. In this lesson, we will learn how constant speed is expressed as a unit rate. I have a friend who trains for marathons. She loves to run. She runs at different speeds on different days to challenge herself or give herself a rest. My friend ran 18 miles today, and it took her 6 hours. If she ran at a constant speed, how many miles did she run in 1 hour? So first things first, let's determine her rate. Let's put the distance on top. 18 miles over the time it took her, which was 6 hours. But now I want this to tell me how many miles she ran in 1 hour. So I need to convert this rate to a unit rate. Now, if you don't know about unit rates, make sure you go back and watch the video called Unit Rates. But if you do know, then you know we need to divide the denominator and the numerator by the same number that will give us a 1 on the bottom. So if I want a 1 on the bottom, I'm gonna have to divide my denominator by 6, so I get 1 hour on the bottom. And 18 divided by 6 gives me 3 miles on the top. So this says my friend ran 3 miles for every 1 hour that she was running. But can you think of another way to say 3 miles for every 1 hour? Yeah, that's right. Miles per hour is how we usually say this. So we can even rewrite this as 3 miles per hour. A constant speed unit rate is where we compare the distance traveled by one unit of time. Some examples of constant speed unit rates are miles per hour, meters per second, or kilometers per hour. Let's practice this with a double number line. Have you heard of Usain Bolt? It's this guy right here. He's one of the fastest sprinters of all time. This is a CK12 simulation of Usain Bolt's races for the 100 meter race and the 200 meter race. You'll see on the top number line, there is the distance he ran, and on the bottom is the time in seconds. So what we can do here is we can take this red dot and we can drag it over to a certain time. So 4 seconds, let's say. 4.02 to be specific. And if I press play, it's going to tell us the distance he ran in that amount of time. So now we can see in 4.02 seconds, he ran 41.95 meters. And this little blue dotted line runs at his rate that he was racing. So let's answer these questions together. The first one says, during the 100 meter race, how far did Usain Bolt run in 1 second? Round to the nearest 1/100th. So if we go up here, it tells us his rate here. So it's 100 meters per 9.58 seconds. But we want to know how far he ran in just 1 second. So in a way, we're just converting this to the unit rate per 1 second. But instead of doing the math, we can just take our little marker here and line it up perfectly with 1 second. And now let's press play. Whoop. And it looks like in 1 second, Usain Bolt ran 10.44 meters. So we can click that for our answer. There it is. Nice. The next question says, what was his speed in meters per second for the 200 meter race? Round your answer to the nearest 1/100th. So his speed in meters per second. So we know that he ran 200 meters per 19.19 seconds. So that's his rate, but we want it in just meters per 1 second. So again, we want to find his unit rate. So can you think of a way to do that mathematically? We could divide the bottom, 19.19, by 19.19 to get 1, and we could also divide 200 by 19.19 to give us how many meters he ran in just 1 second. But once again, we can take our dot and we can bring it down to the 1 second mark, press play, and looks like he went 10.42 meters in just 1 second. So we can say that his speed was 10.42 meters per second. And that's our meters per second unit, 10.42 meters per second. Do-do-do! Nice work. Now let's check out the phet game that you will get to play on your own after this video. In this one, we're also going to have a double number line and we're going to be racing cars. So we're in our phet simulation now. You'll see we have our two race cars and we have our double number lines for the red car up here, blue car down here. So we're going to have the red car and the blue car race. Whoever gets to the flag first is the winner. As you can see, the red car does have to travel farther, so it's not totally a fair fight. In this first race, the red car is traveling at a rate of 50 miles per 2 hour, and the blue car is also traveling at a rate of 50 miles per 2 hours. Let's see who the winner is. Looks like the blue car. Took the blue car 4 hours to go 100 miles, but it took the red car 6 hours to drive 150 miles. So the red car was slower. It did take 2 more hours, but it had to go farther. So on our double number lines here, they've put in our rate, our miles per hour. So it says the red car went 150 miles in 6 hours. What's the unit rate for that? Remember, we divide the bottom by 6 to get 1. So we get a 1 on the bottom. But we also have to divide 150 by 6 to keep it even. So 150 divided by 6 is 25. And let's see about the unit rate for our bottom car. Blue car travels 100 miles in 4 hours. So if we divide the bottom by 4, we get 1 hour. And 100 divided by 4 is 25. So their unit rates are the same, which they should be because their rates were both the same. So they were each traveling 25 miles per hour. What do you think we can do to the rates they're traveling at over here to get them to tie the race? So how would the red car go 150 miles in the same amount of time as the blue car traveling 100 miles? What do you think we could change? Let's think about it here. If the red car goes 25 miles in every hour and it takes him 6 hours, what could we change about the blue car's rate to make it take him 6 hours as well? Yeah, we have to slow him down, right? So we have to reduce his unit rate here, reduce his speed. So what if we make the blue car travel 50 miles every 3 hours? So now he takes an extra hour to go the same distance, 50 miles. Let's see what happens this time. It took them both 6 hours. They tied. You did it. Nice job. But let's see what happened to their unit rates now. The red car stayed the same because we didn't change the red car's rate, 50 miles per 2 hours, unit rate of 25 miles per hour. But what about 6 hours for every 100 miles? Our unit rate changes, so it's 1.5 hours to go 25 miles. But what if we actually want to make this the unit rate? So we're going to divide this now. 6 on the bottom turns to a 1. And what's 100 divided by 6? It's not a totally nice number. It's about 16.7. So now the blue car slowed down to 16.7 miles per hour, whereas the red car was going 25 miles per hour. Great job studying unit rates, where we compared the distance traveled per unit of time. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Keep practicing your constant speed unit rates by playing the game and completing the activities. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.